A mind-blowing 32% fewer homes have come on the market below $750,000, which means the lower price ranges are disappearing. Manuel Sanchez here with your Real Estate Market Report. For the most part, prices do not remain the same, and we all know this. Over time, just about everything becomes more expensive, and housing is not an exception. After a while, society just digests the higher values. In 2013, for example, 89% of home sales were below $750,000. Today, only 61% of total home sales are below the $750,000 mark. As home prices have appreciated over the years, the lower price ranges have dwindled and have become a smaller percentage of the housing stock. And it's not that fewer homeowners within these more affordable price ranges have not placed their home on the market. Instead, it has more to do with home values appreciating and surpassing the lower range thresholds. There's currently 1,022 homes for sale below $750,000, which is 44% of all active listings. Just think about that. Less than half of the homes currently on the market are priced less than $750,000. But okay, what does this all mean? Well, it means that everything is shifting. Homes that were valued at $500,000 a few years ago are now selling for much, much more. And appreciation is kicking in at an extremely fast pace. But is this sustainable? Well, we have yet to see that. Is this another housing bubble? No, not really. But once the summer passes, we might see a softening of the market. Just last week, a federal judge lifted the COVID moratorium for evictions. Does this mean we might see more homes come to market? Are landlords going to be looking to sell because, well, they haven't received rent for the past year? We have yet to see that. Currently, though, homes are selling for way above list price with multiple offers. This is, of course, if the home is priced correctly. I expect this trend to continue as long as the market remains hot. Closed sales in San Diego is off the charts. It has been the strongest start to the year since 2005. Yes, a lot of it is pent-up demand, I know. Buyers were on the sidelines waiting for this pandemic to pass. But demand for homes is at an all-time high, and inventory is at an all-time low. Just take a look at this chart of active listings year over year. We have less active properties currently right now than in 2018, 2019, and 2020. It'll be very interesting to see how the second half of 2021 plays out. If you like more in-depth numbers on certain neighborhoods, please make sure to reach out. Until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.